And welcome back, everybody, to the First Impression series. This is Ryan Man 10,100, and we're back again with the Uncharted franchise because we're going to head into Uncharted: The Lost Legacy for the PlayStation 4. Okay, so this is the game made after Uncharted 4. Uncharted 4, which would pretty much seem like the end of the Uncharted franchise, especially for Nathan Drake. But there are some characters from the franchise that we actually one, needed to dive into more, and two, were missing from Uncharted 4. One of people's fan favorite characters, Chloe, who was a protagonist in 2, Among Thieves, and I think she might show up in Uncharted 3 a little bit. I can't remember off the top of my head. It's been a while since I played Uncharted 3 and finished that game. But yeah, Chloe was nowhere to be seen in Uncharted 4 at all. I know that was more focusing on focusing the story on the Drake brothers, you know, and Nathan Drake's adventure with, you know, with his relationship and you know, his thieving life and his job and all that type of stuff. And I understand that. That type of situation. But also another character that we got in Uncharted 4 was Nadine, who hadn't really, other than Uncharted 4, really didn't dive into the character that much at all. We know that she worked for Shoreline with the antagonist of Uncharted 4. I'm not sure if antagonists, I think, worked for Shoreline. I think Shoreline was just the company that Nadine was under, and they were hired by the antagonist to work with them on uncovering the treasure of Thomas Avery. And yeah, so she was kind of a little bit of a loose thread that wasn't tied up either. So shown off at E3, I think the year that 2017, I believe it was the year after Uncharted 4 came out, Lost Legacy was announced, and took many people by surprise. Is this 2017 or 2018 game? Now, it must have been 2016, so it must have been the E3 just after Uncharted 4 came out, which I believe came out the month before, which I think was May. I think it was around my birthday, I think, when it came out, in 2016. And I think Uncharted Lost Legacy must have been shown at E3 that year, because Lost Legacy came out in 2017. I'm just going to do moderate because I've played the games before. It's good to give me those options, especially if I was the person playing the game was struggling. New game data, yes. Yeah, that'll do, that'll be fine. Because I'm going to be saving anyway, because I want to play more of this game. Because I want to get my Uncharted fix again. It's been a while since I played like an adventure type of game. Last time I played one of these games was actually Tomb Raider. Finishing that off, and that was, it's what, April 2019 now? It's been, I think, late November, I think, was the last time I played and finished a, actually no, it might have been December, so it's been like 4 months-ish, maybe a little bit more, since I last played an adventure-type game, and I wanted to play Uncharted. But, yeah, so we have a couple of loose threads that need to be tied up, and this is the story of Chloe and Nadine working together, I believe, to find a treasure. But wonder if we get, you know, callbacks to, like, Nathan Drake and that sort of thing in the game.
guys do.
Does it now?
Half price if you buy two.
Wow. You again. Is this your store?
No, my father's.
How much?
800 rupees, please.
800 rupees?
Okay, for you, 550.
Incredible. So, does your father usually leave you here alone?
No, he's away fighting the devils.
Indian army called him up, did they?
No, he vanished.
Really? Well, if it was my choice, I wouldn't leave you here alone. All right. That's 300.
Better deal. 400 rupees plus Ganesh.
You don't want this. It's broken. See?
You don't know the story? Ganesh fought Parashuram, was demigod at his father's door.
Yes, to defend the honor of his father, Shiva, and got his tusk hacked off for his troubles.
Interesting.
Anyway, it's not for sale. Right on time. Okay, look. 600 rupees. Keeps changing.
Hey, wait! Hey! You need a guy!
Oh? And what'll that cost me?
My sister needs me.
So, yeah, so I believe we're in Africa. I believe this is where this is set. Whereabouts, I'm not 100% sure. Giving us a tutorial on how the phone works, which is basically like, I'm guessing like Nathan's journal. Okay, so which way are we supposed to go? Let's go this way. Yeah. I don't know why. I keep running into this guy. Hey, are you coming? Thank you. You're supposed to be my guy, you're supposed to be leading the way.
Excuse me.
What?
Don't get me wrong, decent technique on the lift. But I'd like my Ganesh back, please.
Fine.
Day for effort, kid.
Shows you how the treasuring works. So basically, before.
Don't go inside without removing your shoes.
I know. I just wanted to look at the mandapam.
But basically, yeah, the treasures unlock bonuses in the main menus. This has been a thing since the first game, I believe, if not the second one. What those bonuses are, I wouldn't be able to tell you.
People aren't allowed across the bridge. It's too dangerous. my bed in the store. 300 rupees. Best deal in all of India.
Okay.
India. Sorry, my apologies.
Bad idea. The ropes, they hurt people.
Listen, I need to help my friend, okay? Tell you what, when I get back, pizza's on me. Deal?
Deal.
Little girl helped us. Whether that deal goes through or not will have to be seen, because who knows. So yeah, so I believe this segment, I think, was the around the E3 demo. Two photos so far.
Here we go. It's just an active war zone. Nothing you can't handle.
Okay, title card's definitely a little bit different. So we might as well save here. Make an actual save file. There we go. It should auto-save now. Yes, it does. Very good. It's going to be a little bit dark, which is... Be the other way then. Get around that puddle, because it might make some noise. This way.
How do I know you're not smuggling something in here? Arms up.
Hey.
Dangerous to be out so late.
Hey! Where do you live? What are you, deaf? Answer him! I said, where do you live?
I like this one.
I'm in the middle of something.
It's been made.
Yes, sir.
Meet me inside.
Understood. You, with me. Man the gun.
Sir, what about her?
Just let her through.
You heard him. Get going.
Very lucky break there.
Lucky for them, I've got somewhere to be. The door. Check.
Okay, so we're gonna go around this way.
Not this way.
Can't go that way. Okay, so we have to go this way instead. Trying to instinctively crouch. And it's not gonna work. Especially in this instance, it's gonna be fucking weird. Okay. Nice. Damn, Chloe. Nice.
Come along, friend.
Yeah. We should get off the streets.
Our shift ends in an hour.
You need sleep?
You can sleep in the truck.
No.
Is that the last of
them? Okay.
Almost. There's a couple more in the alley.
Moving up there.
Oh, shit. Great timing.
Tired of it. So, Asad says 1 week. You're gonna be shit home. Remember?
Yeah.
There's like some bombings or something going on. Not sure what. Jeez, that was quick. Okay, so we can vault over this, which is great. Yep. There's warfare going on, and oh, Jesus, that guy. Plane just crashed. The fuck is going on?
One was the warehouse, the other... You're in the wrong place, girl. What the hell? I punched you.
Thank you.
You're late, Fraser. I see you too.
Holy shit! Did the one of us squad?
What the hell was that? I thought you were a professional.
Oh, you should relax. Live longer.
Relax? It took me weeks to track down Asof. The man's as unpredictable as they come.
It's just another warmonger with no water fight.
No, you don't know him like I do. He changes location and routines by the hour. We'd be foolish to take unnecessary risks.
We? Let's get one thing straight. This is my gig. You want your share? We play by my rules. the one with the dead. That's the spirit.
So I have a feeling they're gonna like each other a bit more later on in the game.
Handsome.
If you're into psychopaths.
Nobody's perfect. Where's base camp?
Top floor balcony.
Alright. Let's do this.
Hit a street route all planned out. They'll be looking for us. What do you suggest?
I'll think of something.
Okay. What did we just get? Oh, we got the people. Okay.
Your boost up. There you go.
And I drop down the ladder for me.
Thank you.
At least the climbing feels just as good as before.
Follow me.
Now what?
Oh, they just jumped onto the thing.
Up here.
Really? Really?
Along this one. You sure this is safe?
Jeez. Well, it's the only way we're not gonna get fucking caught. That's for sure. And plus, it's the only, like, real safe way that goes down. I was holding it and it wasn't doing anything. Where do we jump to now? Not there. Gonna learn by experience, boys. Oh, okay.
Really?
Yeah, I was gonna say there's gonna be a death plane down here. Yeah.
Up here.
Really? Really?
Considering it gave me.
No.
There you go, boys. You learn by experience. And if you've played the series long enough, you know where the death plane's usually probably signified.
This way. We realize we're moving away from the soft state. Yeah, we're taking the long way. But now people are always connected.
Yep. See, I'm so used to like the white description on the wall. It was something that you can vault up in Tomb Raider. Military service lighter. Okay. Boxes to go where? Guessing it's for this. Is it for this? Jump up here? Probably. Gee, that was a good catch.
Just exploring our options. sit tight. Well, she certainly lives up to her reputation.
I was going to say, this is a wet pipe that should be giving me a bit more struggle. But anyway. No. Drag back. And then drop down over here. Oops.
Sorry about that. How about we avoid crates from now on? Okay, good deal.
Aw, oh, this is like some of my favorite things in Uncharted. Fuck. Jeez, I missed that. Just noticed I missed that. Comes with the territory. Supposed to go in there. Run and jump, I reckon. Run and jump. Yep, got pole. Very good. Okay, and I'm gonna go roll all the way back. And jump. Would have missed that too. Whee! Hang down before.
Just above us. See, that wasn't so bad. It wasn't.
Not kidding. It really wasn't. Took a little bit longer than I expected, yes, but got there alive. Lucky there was an alarm on the fucking thing.
Thank you very much. Watch our backs, yeah? Yeah. Crossed. It's like walking to an antique shop. He's been a busy boy.
How much do you think it's worth? Really
enough to keep his little insurrection going for quite some time. Indian Christian. Is that it? No. Just look out.
It doesn't bother me. These are all Indian out of it.
Not my fight. Salah and the tiger. Maybe he's closer than I thought.
Same over there, all the way over here.
Ivory traded to. Ah, sorry.
I'm guessing Chloe's been trying to find something like that for a while. Just let out some.
goddess of love.
So where is our little treasure? I'm guessing it's the map.
I'll just borrow this.
Fraser.
Mm-hmm.
Come here.
That looks promising.
It's locked.
Not for long.
I do like the lock picking thing. It's a good idea. I like that.
No, it's alright. Nothing we didn't already know.
See, I'm thinking of like a safe where I'm doing the reverse direction every time I hit the thing.
Nadine Ross. What a pleasant surprise. Careful with the brothers. This tiger's got claws.
A soul.
Oh, all these years. And you haven't aged a day.
You're too kind. Are you looking for work?
I hear that Shoreline's under new management.
Temporary setback. Nothing I can't handle.
Of course, of course. Pretty though. My men and I could use someone of your caliber. Why are you here? And this isn't your area of expertise.
It is a nice collection, I must say. Chloe Fraser, collector of antiquities.
A thief? You're working for a thief.
Sir, we have a situation.
I'll be right back. The disc.
Oh, right, about that. At first, I mistook you for just an average rebel. But you have managed to find the Hoysala Empire. That's not bad. Their greatest treasure, the task of Ganesh. Now that's not an easy fight.
What are you doing?
3 Persian invasions, 3 separate wars, and all these years later, no one has found it.
We're close.
You're lost. And the only chance you have of even narrowing down its location is to find someone who can help you crack this artifact.
Someone with an extensive knowledge of Hoysala society.
Exactly.
Which Chloe is.
History.
My rates are reasonable.
A parasite who exploits our struggle in order to fatten her pockets.
So that's a no. Don't like a no.
You've got balls. I like that. But I don't need any more so-called experts. Shoot them. Throw their bodies in the river.
No need.
Throw
ourselves out.
There we go. Through the window.
Come on. We need to get across the river.
Ow. And there goes another lot of set of light bulbs. Oh, it's supposed to go down. that way.
This way!
And I was gonna say we're gonna go down here.
What the hell was that back there?
Messy but effective.
You were going to sell me out, weren't you? It's called improvisation. God, who's being unprofessional now? What the hell is that supposed to mean?
It means you let Asav get the jump on us. I'm starting to wonder whether you're worth the 50%.
I knew it. You were going to give me up. This Olympic can't change of spots.
You know nothing about me.
Fair warning. Last person who betrayed me wound up dead. There's your river.
Yeah? And your guy better be there.
Shit! Time to go! Come on! Right behind you!
Ow.
Oh, this is dangerous! Jump!
There we go. Sign. And yet it didn't jump me like 50 feet in the air again. Go that way either. Okay, I was supposed to go that way, just not in that spot. Missed that one too. No, I'll go that way. I'll go this way instead. This is pretty good so far. I'm actually really enjoying it. But I don't know who the enemy is.
How are we going out there?
On schedule. Should hit land in about an hour.
Great.
The Tusk of Ganesh. No wonder the High Solar Capital was ransacked. Look at this thing. Any luck?
I don't need luck.
I'd say we can use all the luck we can get.
Are you still hung up on Asav's so-called expert? Don't worry.
If Asav's not in the gates already, he'll be right on our heels. Plus, he's got weapons, transports, hundreds of men.
Like I said, don't worry.
Looks like some kind of key.
Maybe. Let's see. Trident was Ganesh's weapon. The bow and arrow was Parashurama's. And the axe was a gift from Shiva. The great battle.
What?
battle in which Ganesh lost his tusk. And I bet we find these symbols. We find the tusk. Not bad, Fraser. Yeah, well. You're like my dad for that Hindu mitzvah his thing. I'd have rubbed off. You must be proud. Sun's almost up. I'll go get ready.
Obviously, she doesn't want to talk about her dad. She might have been pretty close to him. So, like, Avery's treasure was for Nathan Drake. Maybe this treasure is for... It's the same type of thing for Chloe.
Peace of mind, all right? Well, nice view. And look. How weird. I'm sorry I doubted you, Chloe.
Is there Salah?
Oui, Salah. It's not a modern structure, so we're definitely on the right track. What?
I don't like it.
You don't like anything?
No. We've gone nearly 100 kilometers with no sign of a Sov.
Glass half full, maybe we got the jump on them.
Unlikely.
I'll find the tusk. A Sov's on you.
Understood.
Yeah, so I'm liking the... The compromisation between Nadine and Chloe. It's, oh geez, that is a nice photo. I like that. That's really good.
Oh,
what am I doing? Not phone. Okay, so I'm going to leave it there. I'm going to save again. Well, it's going to auto-save anyway, but I usually save myself. Regardless. So what do I think of Uncharted Lost Legacy so far? I'm actually really, really enjoying it. It's definitely getting right into the action, but doesn't start out with a look into the future like most of the other games have. I think it's more like Uncharted 1 in that structure where it's, you know, it isn't flashing back with most of the game. It's like flashing forward and then it's flashing back afterwards. With a lot of the game, and then it leads up to that point where you play that part that you played at the start of the game again, but makes sense with the context of the rest of the game. And it's kind of weird that that's not a thing, but I'm guessing that's been more of a thing with the Nathan Drake story more so than anything else. But I'm really enjoying the game. Still feels very Uncharted-y. There was a lot of jumps that I missed, either killing myself or visually you could see it happening. And I'm really enjoying the game. It is particularly one of this series is one of my particular favourites, and I'm really excited to see where Lost Legacy kind of deviates from the rest. I mean, it's already got that lockpicking type minigame that Chloe has, more so than Nathan Drake, because I don't think Nathan Drake did anything like that in that particular way, so it kind of, you know, has her own unique gameplay structures and gameplay gimmicks compared to something like a character like Nathan Drake. But it's great. It's great return to form. Well, I wouldn't say it's great return to form, because Uncharted 4 was pretty damn good game in its own right as well. But it's a nice return for me, which is great, and I'm going to love to see where this story goes and where it kind of connects in the timeline with everything else, because it kind of feels like it's after Uncharted 4, just due to the fact that you know, Shoreline's under new management, and the situation of Nadine saying that she trusted someone last time and they died was the antagonist from Uncharted 4. So yeah, so it's kind of interesting to see where this story goes, especially with the characterization of Chloe and Nadine and their friendship and bond maybe becoming stronger throughout the game. We'll have to wait and see if that happens. But yeah, thank you guys so much for watching this huge, long, first impressions video of Uncharted Lost Legacy. Sorry about that. Just, you know, it's one of the ways you know how I absolutely love this game, or love these games, is that the videos go on forever. This is Mario Man 2100. Thank you guys so much for watching this first impressions video. It's, like I said, it's been Mario Man 2100. You guys have a great day or night, and of course, take care. Messed up the outro. Messed up the outro. And messed up saying that sentence too. See, it's the end of the video. Thanks guys for watching. See ya.